active index of material of the prism. Material of the prism. So this is the topic. Refractive index is nothing but the comparison of the velocity of the light in air and to the medium, right? So the medium here, what we are taking, the prism material is the medium. So let us draw. This is the base of the prism. So let it be named as a ABC. The prism is nothing but the triangular base, cylindrical, a glass transparent substance. That one. And here the light ray can enter in one face of the prism, where here the normal can be drawn, right? The normal is going to be drawn like this one initially, and here is the point of incident. The light ray is traveling like we can name as a P, and this normal drawn is nothing but N1, first normal, right? And the light ray incident this one at the point of Q, and it refracts in the within the prism material, right? So as it refracts, it makes some refractive angle with the normal, let us to be R1, and this is the angle of incidence, I1. But when the ray comes within the prism material, it travels in a straight line, and that may be parallel or may not be parallel to the base. It depends on the angle of incidence, right? And here, at this point, if you can draw one more normal, and that can be joints here, and these two normals are going to be joined at a point N, you can say. Now this is N2. Now here this refracted ray comes out of the prism like emergent ray, you can say. What we call?
Emergent ray.
Emergent ray. And this incident ray is refract like this and comes out from the prism in the direction of, this is R and S, you can take R and
S.
Now here the second refractive angle is nothing but R2, and here the emerging angle is also can be called as a angle of incidence. Why? Because the light ray may travel like this and it may refract and it maybe comes out. So that is why your emerging ray also can be treated as a incident ray. So that is why this angle is also called as an angle of incidence or angle of incidence. I2 we can consider. Now if I extend this incident ray and emergent ray, they can be meet at a point
P.
And here, this incident ray may travel like this one if there is no prism. But because of the prism, what happened? It bends like this one. So how much deviation takes place? The deviation is nothing but D. Here, angle of deviation is how much? D, you can say. Now, this is a perfect diagram is framed here. Incident ray, incident at Q, refracts as a QR, and comes out as emergent ray as RS. Now we are going to prove that. What is that one? Refractive index of the prism material by the Snell's law. By the
Snell's law.
What Snell's law is there?
Sin A by sin R.
Now from this one proof, we take this one. That opportunity, what is happening? What? Here triangle is there, Q, N, R. The sum of the angles in a triangle is always 180 degrees. And we will take quadrilateral A, Q, N, R. In this quadrilateral, this opposite angle sum is nothing but
180 degrees.
Right? So therefore, we can take this one. Let ABC be the base of the prism. Base of the
prism,
you can say. Right? Now, PQ is incident ray. Incident ray. And here QR is refracted ray. Refracted ray. And RS is
emergent
ray. Emergent. Now from that angle, if you can write triangle, what is this one? QNR. If you can write QNR. So here R1 plus R2 plus N is equal to
180.
We say that one sum of the angles in a triangle is always be equal to
180.
Now let this to be, it is one equation. Again, quadrilateral. Here Q, N, R, A. You can say angle A plus N. Angle N plus A is equal to also
180 degrees.
You can say it is equation
2.
But by this what you can write? R1 plus R2 plus N is equal to N plus A. Because the right hand side the sum is equal. Thereby we can equate these two equations. So, like terms can be cancelled. Then what you can write?
R1 plus R2 is equal to A.
This equation
3.
Now coming to the point at Q and coming to the point at R. Here we have that one vertically opposite angles. At a point if the two rays are going to be joined here, then angle of incidence is nothing but, here let us take one more angle, what is that one?
X.
And here what is angle?
Y.
Right? So therefore here at Q, what you can say? The diagram I am drawing. This is the what diagram here. So this is I1. And here X is R. So what else you can write here?
I1
is equal to X plus
R.
X plus
R.
This is equation
4.
Similarly, at R you can say, this is the way, here you can take Y angle and this is
R2
angle, this is I2 angle. Then what is the equation you can write here?
I2
is equal to
R2
plus
Y.
It is equation
5.
Let us add. Let us add 4 and
5,
you can say, equations. So what else you can find? I1 plus
I2.
So here I1 plus
I2
is equal to R1
plus
X, R2 plus
Y.
Right? Here I1 plus I2 is equal to R1 plus R2 plus
X plus
Y. But from the triangle, here Q, P, R you can take. Q,
P,
R. So like this you can write. Here it is angle D. It is X, it is Y. So what else you can write here?
X
plus Y is equal to
D.
So here X and Y are the interior opposite angles. And here D is what?
Exterior
angle. So therefore this exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior
opposite angles.
So thereby, this I1 plus I2 is equal to R1 plus
R2
plus
D.
And it is equation
6.
But R1 plus R2 is equal to what?
A.
So thereby, here I1 plus I2 is equal to
A plus
D. You can write, you make it 6.
7.
Right on. find from equation 3, we can write that R1 plus R2 is equal to A. And these two we are substituting in this one, thereby the equation has become I1 plus I2 is equal to A plus B. So far what we derived, I1 plus I2 is equal to be derived, and R1 plus R2 is equal to be derived, right? But to prove that one's Lenz law, N is equal to sin A by
sin A.
To make that incident angle or refracted angle, as you are going to be, the angle of incidence when you are going to be increased gradually, then what happened here, you see, if angle of incidence, if it is normal, this is the angle of incidence, this is the angle of incidence, this is the angle of incidence. For this various angle of incidence, the extension can be done like this one, right? And what are these one? Emergent waves. And this angle of deviations are also quite big, different. So if you can draw ID curve, the ID curve. ID curve is nothing but for the various angle of incidence taken on x-axis, various angle of deviations taken on y-axis. So you will be find a depression curve like this one, you will be find. That means as the angle of incidence is increasing, the angle of deviation gradually decreases and again increases. But at certain point where it decrease and increase, it is called angle of minimum deviation. Angle of
minimum deviation.
Right. So at angle of minimum deviation, what we can write here, I1 is equal to I2. When I1 is equal to I2, what happens? This QR makes perfectly parallel to BC. Right? Thereby R1 is equal to also R2 it becomes. Right? So here QR is parallel to which one?
BC,
base of the prism. Then it implies what you can write? I1 is equal to I2. And R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R2. Here I. Where you are writing? At capital D. At capital D, you can write this. Thereby equation 6 and equation 3 becomes. Equation 3 becomes. What you can write? R plus R is equal to A. It implies 2R is equal to A and R is equal to A by 2. Right? Similarly, equation 6 becomes here I plus I is equal to A plus D, capital D, because not small d, because at minimum deviation only that might be possible. Right? So here what you can write, I plus I is nothing but 2i, A plus D, right? I is equal to A plus D by 2. Now we got angle of refraction, you got angle of incidence, you got. But what is A here? This A is what? Angle of the prism. For regular prisms, that means all the sides must be equal. That is to be called the regular prism. The regular prism, all angles are equal. That means each angle is what? 60 degrees. Yes. Right? Isosceles prisms are there and regular prisms are there like that. Basically, most of the experiments we can use only regular prisms. Now here, using Snell's law. From Snell's law. So what you can write? N is equal to, what is N? Refractive index of material of prism. Material of
prism.
Prism. So this N is equal to
sin I by
sin R.
this I value A plus D by 2 and R value A by 2. If you can substitute in this one, N is equal to sine of A plus D by 2 by sine of A by 2. So this is the formula to derive the refractive index of the material of the prism. Right? And it is a total explanation about this one. The base of the prism and the QR is parallel. Then only you can say that when I1 is equal to I2 or R1 is equal to R2. Because perfect parallel. So angle of incident and angle of emergence both should be equal. First refracted angle, second refracted angle, both should be equal. Then only the QR must be very parallel to BC. So that's the way, and you can find out the refractive index of the material of the prism. If you can substitute angle of prism A is equal to 60 degrees, then it is 60 by 2. Sine 30 is nothing but 1 by 2. 1 by 2, the 2 will be multiplied here. Then if another supposition 60 degrees, then N is equal to 2 into sine of 60 plus D by 2, you can write. This is the one more reduction formula for the sake of that one. By substituting A is equal to 60 degrees. The angle of the prism 60 degrees. For regular prisms only it is possible. So this is my conclusion about the refractive index of the prism material.